All right, I'm back for the third D. We have been covering subluxation, which is neurological interference in between our brain and our body. What feeds that subluxation, the three T's, thoughts, traumas, and toxins, and the effects of those, the neurological compromise that starts to occur. So we covered the first D, dyskinesia, when there's a misalignment and a fixation and the brain's not getting the right feedback, with disaffrontation being affected as well. Now we start to see something called dysautonomia. And dys meaning, once again, a dysfunction. Autonomia meaning your autonomic nervous system. So everything that's on autopilot inside of our body, which 300 trillion bits of information reach our brain every second, we're consciously aware of 50 of those signals. It's pretty important that that guy's running up to snuff. So what we'll start to see, typically in this order, but not always, is the gut starts to be affected, the immune system, and also the endocrine system. Your brain requires so much nutrients, so much oxygen, and when it's running the show and it's stealing all of those nutrients, we start to see other effects inside of the body. And when somebody comes in with stomach issues, with eating issues, with GI upset, maybe with some constipation, diarrhea, we know that there's probably already dyskinesia and disaffrontation occurring to get to the point of this dysautonomia, and an immune system that's either overstimulated or understimulated, and also an endocrine system. So that's your hormones. That's your hormone cycle. We'll see oversized or undersized children, children that probably aren't getting enough nutrients from their food, as well as adults. We know how important our hormone cycles are, and when those are thrown off, man, mom and dad don't feel good, the kids don't feel good, and it's a recipe for disaster. So I want you guys to stay tuned for our fourth and fifth D that are coming up next, so you know what the neurological effects of a subluxation are, and you start to hear this story.